Hello and welcome to Izmir, the third largest city in Turkey. Turkish Airlines offers frequent departures between Izmir and Istanbul every day. Sometimes it even uses a Boeing 777 wide-body aircraft. And guess how much a business class ticket costs on this route? Less than $100. This surely is an experience that I don't want to miss. So, let's go!
Izmir is a fast-growing city on the central Aegean coast of Turkey. It has an urban population of over 3 million and has one of the major ports in the Mediterranean. Due to its favorable geographical location, climate, water resources and fertile lands, this 8,500-year-old city has been a home of many civilizations and cultures. Izmir Adnan Menderes International Airport is the fifth busiest airport in Turkey, located 18 kilometers southwest of the city. The easiest way to get there is by taking the eastbound commuter train. It departs Alsancak station every 10 to 20 minutes, and the ride takes around 25 minutes. The station is located adjacent to the domestic terminal building. Izmir Airport has two terminals, one for domestic and the other for international flights. To enter either terminal, all bags and personal belongings must go through the X-ray machine. Once inside, a 400-meter-long walkway connects the two buildings. The international terminal was completed in 2016 to accommodate the increasing passenger traffic. In 2019, the airport handled over 12.8 million passengers. Due to limited time, I didn't go upstairs to check out the international departures area. Turkish Airlines is a flag carrier of Turkey, a member of the Star Alliance and one of the world's largest airlines. Its check-in counters at the domestic terminal are conveniently located in the center of the building, right next to the security lanes. Other than the economy class lane, all business class passengers, Star Alliance Gold members and Turkish Airlines Classic Plus tier members can use the priority lane. After checking in, passengers need to go through another security check to get to the boarding gate. Eligible Turkish Airlines passengers can use the dedicated security lane and head straight to the lounge. The experience is similar to using the Qantas Premium Lounge entry at Brisbane's domestic terminal. However, I decided to use the general security lane as the line wasn't long this morning. After the security, there are plenty of shops, restaurants and cafes for passengers to explore. Overall, this terminal is modern, clean and easy to navigate. There's even an outdoor smoking deck at the end of the building. As of 2022, Turkish Airlines flies to more countries than any other airlines in the world. It operates scheduled services to 126 countries and 340 destinations. Although most of the wide-body aircraft are used on its long-haul routes, Turkish Airlines also uses them on some of its high-density domestic routes. My flight to Istanbul this morning will be flown by a Boeing 777 aircraft. Turkish Airlines has two lounges at the domestic terminal. The entry is located opposite gate 242. At the time of filming, the lounges open daily from 1:30 a.m. to 11 p.m. They are situated on the ground floor. If I chose to use the private security lane after getting my boarding pass, this is where I would end up, skipping the hustle and bustle of the departures level completely. Turkish Airlines' frequent flyer program is called Miles and Smiles. Classic Plus is equivalent to the Star Alliance Silver tier. Elite is equal to Star Alliance Gold, and Elite Plus is also Star Alliance Gold, but its members can enjoy more perks when flying with Turkish. Passengers flying in domestic economy with Classic Plus or Star Alliance Gold status can use the Classic Plus and Elite lounge before boarding. For Elite Plus and Business Class passengers, including myself, can use this one. The lounge names are pretty self-explanatory. Both lounges offer similar facilities and both have apron views. But as the Elite Plus and Business Lounge has stricter entry requirement, it is less crowded than the other one. The Business Lounge has plenty of different seating with power plugs next to most of them. There's also a media corner, a business center, and lockers for charging your electronic devices. The toilets include a baby change room, but I don't think there's a shower here. Regarding the food, there's a buffet area with a variety of fruits, yogurts, cheeses, salads. Cookies, cakes, different pastries, and a hot soup. For drinks, there's water, juice, soft drinks, a coffee machine, and of course, you can make yourself a cup of Turkish tea. I knew I would be having a big meal on the plane, so I only got myself a small sandwich and tea. Boarding for my flight commenced 60 minutes before departure. I was ready to head back upstairs, and as I walked out of the lounge, the staff told me that I could actually board from the lounge. What a surprise! The way it works is that when a flight starts boarding, passengers can head to the dedicated boarding area inside the lounge. The staff will then scan the boarding pass, and the private shuttle bus will take passengers to the bottom of the aero bridge. Doing so saves passengers from having to walk from the lounge to the boarding gate. I had never experienced this before. It was interesting and I was impressed with how organized everything was. Turkish Airlines has 33 Boeing 777-300ER aircraft in its fleet. Compared to the Boeing 787 and A350 aircraft, which have newer, all-aisle access business class seats, the Boeing 777 features the airline's old product, introduced in 2010. The seats are in a 2-3-2 configuration. There are four rows in the forward cabin, followed by another three rows behind door two. The downsides of the 2-3-2 setup are the horrible middle seat in the center and the lack of direct aisle access for passengers in the window seat. For this flight, I picked seat 6K. While privacy is lacking, these forward-facing seats do have one advantage. There's a significant amount of legroom. Each seat has a width of 22 inches and a pitch of 78 inches. Below the footrest, there's sufficient space to fit a backpack. Although being an old product, the seat can be turned into a fully flat bed. You can also adjust the recline position through the control panel. The tray table is hidden inside the armrest. It's large and stable. Within the central console, there's a universal power plug, a USB port, a headphone jack, and a remote to control the 15.4-inch entertainment screen. However, as this flight is usually just 50 minutes long, the screen remained off for the whole time. Shortly after I settled into my seat, the cabin crew offered business class passengers a range of freshly squeezed juice and a menu for breakfast. Quickly reading through the menu, I thought I had four choices: daily special, scrambled eggs, regional cheeses, and pastries. Having flown Turkish Airlines in the past, I know they have one of the best in-flight food in the world, therefore I'm looking forward to enjoying this meal. Behind the business class section are 300 economy class seats in a welcoming 3-3-3 configuration instead of the 3-4-3 layout that we'll find on most airlines today. This allows each seat to have a width of 18 inches, slightly wider than those on Emirates, Etihad and Qatar's 777s. Just before pushing back, the cabin crew allowed me to move from seat 6K to 5K so I could have both the window and the aisle seat to myself. Izmir Airport has two runways, but they cannot operate simultaneously due to their proximity. Therefore, runway 16 left, 34 right is used as a primary runway, and 16 right, 34 left is available for use as a backup where the main runway is unavailable. This is what the seat looks like when it's in a fully reclined position. The bed is roomy and is over 6 feet long. And I just realized that the armrest can be raised to create a privacy divider with the seat next to you. This Boeing 777 should be equipped with Wi-Fi. However, just like the entertainment screen, the crew did not activate it. Now it's time to show you the most exciting part of this flight, the business class meal. Reading the menu earlier, I thought I had to choose from one of the listed four options, and I was ready to pick the omelette. To my surprise, it turned out that the menu is actually a list of everything on the plate. Here's a comparison picture of a Virgin Australia business class meal I had for breakfast in early 2022. The Turkish Airlines meal looks fresh, healthy, and is so colorful. For drinks, I could choose between tea and coffee, and then from a variety of cold drinks and juice. All meals on Turkish Airlines are prepared in accordance with Islamic principles. Unfortunately, special dietary meals are only available on international flights, and you have to place your request at least 24 hours before departure. This meal was delicious and the portion was excellent. It was perfect for me. I would rate it a 10 out of 10. But I know many of my friends do not like mushrooms and some passengers might be vegan. Given that it's impossible to pre-arrange a special meal, I think Turkish Airlines should offer 2 to 3 choices on its domestic business class service. The flight time to Istanbul today was just 45 minutes. The plane had already commenced its descent while I was finishing my food. Overall, I have absolutely enjoyed my experience today. The lounge was clean and the atmosphere was relaxing. The wide-body aircraft made the journey extra comfortable. The crew were attentive. And lastly, for such a short flight, I am impressed with the portion, the presentation, and the taste of the food that they served. I paid 1,740 Turkish lira for this flight, which is equivalent to just 135 Australian dollars. Istanbul has two international airports. The one on the Asian side of the city is Istanbul Sabiha Gökçen International Airport. It's the hub for Turkey's low-cost carrier Pegasus Airlines and Anadolu Jet, and it's the second busiest airport in Turkey. It handled 35 million passengers in 2019. My flight will be landing at the new Istanbul Airport on the European side. This airport commenced passenger operation in 2019, replacing Atatürk Airport as the main international hub of Istanbul. Although for the moment the airport has only one terminal building, by 2025, when its construction will be entirely completed, this aviation hub will have four terminals and it will be able to handle over 150 million passengers each year. Our plane parked at the international gate after landing. As a result, we disembarked the plane through the stairs and were transported to the domestic arrivals area by the shuttle bus. Welcome to Istanbul. This terminal building is gigantic. It has an area of 1,440,000 square meters, making it the world's largest airport terminal under a single roof. It has the capacity to handle 90 million passengers annually. It took me 15 minutes to walk from one end of the checking area to the other. Thank you so much for watching. If you find this video interesting, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more flight and train reviews. For my next video, I will travel to Cairo and show you the most luxurious and beautiful train journey in Egypt. See you there!